Replenished with the water, the journey continued with haste, but somehow they find themselves separated. Professor Lidenbrook's nephew, Axel, found himself alone. His mind was seized with unparalleled fear, and he saw memories of home flashing before him. His fiancée, Groben, his house and friends in Hamburg. He saw hallucinations of all the incidents of the journey. And unworthy as he felt, he knelt in fervent prayer, and then in panic, he ran blindly through a tunnel, only to reach a dead end, where he fell panting for breath. In the darkness he cried. Voices, 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 he heard voices. He heard his uncle's voice. Due to the shape of the gallery and the conducting power of the rocks, his uncle's voice was uncannily traveling around the walls. And by means of their chronometers, they discovered they were 4 miles apart. So Axel set about the task of rejoining the professor and their guide.
Of a life on earth go flashing past, of home of Grubbin, friends of whom he's seen his last. Contemplating what his life's been worth, while trapped beneath the earth, an embryo at birth. Pain and fear destroy the beauty I have seen of caverns where no other man has ever been. Solarian epoch hosts me as my grave. My final bow I wait, a life too late to save.
Crystals of a pink quartz that in limpid tears, forming magic chandeliers. Light and blistered
disappeared from beneath his feet. He fell down a vertical shaft, his head hitting a sharp rock. He lost consciousness. On opening his eyes, he found himself with the professor and the guide. And looking around him, he saw an ocean stretching as far as the eye could see, a giant forest of mushrooms, a line of huge cliffs, and strange clouds hung overhead as he lay on a deeply indented shore of golden sand strewn with shells. For a moment he thought he was back on the surface of the earth, but he soon realized that they had reached a world within a world.